Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome to Sosnovka. This is our very first episode on this map, and it's our third episode of the day since Farming Simulator 17 has been released. And it appears that I have kind of sorted my issues with the lighting and everything from that first awful video that I am very, very sorry was so horribly late. It was really, really late. Here in Sosnovka, we have got two Zeta tractors. They're actually brand spanking new tractors, they are. Shiny new ones. Is there anything about the actual map on the map overview? It doesn't appear to be. It doesn't give us like the description like it used to. Which is a bit of a shame. I would like to have heard a little bit about it. Something about a farming co-op, I think it was. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. I have already started the case combine. We have one case combine. He's going over there. And the reason I've started him up, set him going, because we've already seen that in the last episode. I got our two Zeta tractors here. One of those will be used on the trailer to go and empty the case combine. We've got another field that we own. And I don't want to go there. I want to go here. And I want to go through here. I will eventually get used to how these things work. So, yeah, over here. I love this, being able to zoom in on the map. This is absolutely fantastic. This is just what is making this game for me already. So yeah, field 19, that one is busy being harvested, and if we take a look at the soil composition, everything needs ploughing once again. We're not going to worry about ploughing for now though. We've got that one, he's cultivated, he's ready to sow, so we will sow that field. I'll put some hired help in there, they can start sowing that field, and then we're going to buy some animals, and I think we're going to go for cattle first. I think we can get the most money out of cattle. So we need to just take a quick look over here at the animals here. So cows is the one that we're going to want. Reproduction rate next animals. We've got liquid manure. We want water. We want straw. We want grass, silage or hay, and power food. And I'm assuming that the power food is the mixed feed, unless there's something else that we can get. So let's come out of there. Let's just take a look. Do you buy power food or something in here? You've got pallets. Seed, solid fertilizer, liquid, pig food, poplar and pallet saplings, poplar saplings. Right, yeah, so there's nothing in there, nothing in the pallets. Place balls, belts, low loaders, animals. What's in here? You got the aquatrans, that will move the water, so we'll need that one. And we also need to get the Joskin trailer so that we can bring the animals here. We got a Silo King there, it's a great big one. Yeah, I could, right, let's get started. Let's actually do something here instead of just talking about it. Come on, Frith, pull yourself together. So let's get started on this one. We're going to take the Zeta Forterra HD. I don't actually know much about Zetas. I drove a really old one, which was one of the most stable tractors I have ever been in. We would go on to land that was so ridiculously steep. That's the button I'm looking for. You wouldn't believe how steep that land was. It was frightening. You really thought the tractor would tip over. It would never tip over. It would go over anything. Right, so the Power 120 is slightly lower horsepower than the Forterra HD. So we'll use the Forterra to do the sowing, and we'll use the other one, I can't even remember what it's called, the Forterra HD, and then what was the other one? It's this one over here. This is the Proxima. Anyway, jump into there. So yeah, the Zeta Forterra HD. This is the one that we use for doing the sowing. And then the other one can go on to the tractor with... Actually, we're going to need another tractor, aren't we? We'll probably just park that trailer in the field, and then the case combine can unload just into the trailer while it's in the field. And then we'll be able to use the other one as when we need it. Now, what's that over there? We've got this grain here. Seeds. If you have the coin to spare, you can refill your sewing machine at these pallets. The same pallets can also be found at the garden center. Oh. I thought you had to use the box things. What's this? Fertilizer drive this tank to fill your sprayers. Ah. No, I thought you had to use the buy those box things. Or maybe it's just on the Goldcrest Valley map. Maybe they don't have refill points. But anyway, we can do it here. We can back up to this one and we can refill right here. So, let's do that a minute. You're not very fast going backwards. Back up. A little bit more. And I'm assuming it's still R, is it, to refill? Yes, it is still R. What are we going to plant here? And now I know that pigs need all sorts of different food, but we're not worrying about pigs just first off. So let's go for something that's going to give us a bit of cash. We want a cash crop. Well, let's just scroll through them and see what we've got. Y to change a seed, isn't it? So we've got barley. We've got wheat over in that field over there. We've got oilseed rape normally gives you a reasonable amount of money, doesn't it? Which way? I want to go over this way. My field's down here. Just got through the side. That's a silage bunker there, that great big long one. We'll be using that. Beans? No, I'm not going to grow beans this time. That's the oilseed radishes. That's the cover crop. We don't want to do that one. I am interested to see how the... Right, that's grass, wheat, barley. You know what? Let's just go for barley. We'll just go for a bog standard barley. We don't have any front weight, so we won't worry about that. And I'll park that one right there and just set it going with the hired help. What I am interested to see is the hired help used to struggle when you had angled fields like that. It would come out to the end and then it wouldn't want to turn round. So how much further will it be able to go on an angled corner like that? So that's something that I'm quite looking forward to finding out. I'm not going to bother asking you about my weekly question on here just yet, or like this week, probably. I don't know. I'll throw it in every now and then because it's about the time lapse. Well, okay. My weekly question, while we're here, when I start doing my time lapse for this Sunday, I will start recording it soon. What I need to know is, do you want me to start recording it on hard difficulty or normal difficulty? I'll be playing it over on Goldcrest Valley. It's your vote, it's your game. Head to the comment section down below and let me know what you think. You will not have long, only maybe, I think I may even start recording that one tomorrow. It takes quite a while and I do it in a lot of stages. So I may even start recording that tomorrow. You won't have long to get me an answer to that question. Although most people seem to have it in for me and want me to do it on hard difficulty. So yeah, thanks for that, everyone. Yeah, cheers. Nice one. It's possible to lose the game on hard difficulty. I did mention that. You're just setting me up to fail, aren't you? That's what it is. You're just setting me up to fail. It's just like some great big joke to you all, isn't it? Okay. I don't really pull off being stroppy very well. Anyway, right, that seems to be doing just fine. There's no problem there. That's something I'm quite keen to see with like wider headers and that is, does it just sort of come out to the end and stop, or will it keep going? So the next thing that we want is we want to get some animals. Now, if you press F1, open animal dialogue. Now, I know this because my youngest son, he was desperate to have a go on this. He wanted to come round. We were picking things up. We were throwing them around. Earlier on today, I did go in blind to Goldcrest Valley. Don't worry, I did do what I said I was going to do. But we had a bit of a play around. We were throwing chairs in front of traffic and doing stuff like that. And we did stumble across this open animal dialogue thing. So I have seen this previously. Now, this is something that is just amazing to look at. There, right. I used the scroll button, just the scroll wheel on my mouse, and it went to 1. Now, are you watching? Zip. Look at that. No longer will you have to click the button thousands of times when you want to buy. You had to click it 3 times per animal that you wanted to get. You don't have to do that anymore. You can just do it like this. However, there is a fee for transporting the animals. Although they're very expensive. Right, let's go back out of there. Is insert still the cash one? Nope. Right, how do I speak to the bank manager? It used to be the insert key. It's not any longer. I need to find where the bank manager is. Now, we used to be able to go to a phone, didn't we, and speak to him? We could just ring him up. I need to take out a bit more loan because I want to get some animals. Now, this here is the silos. Symbols display to retrieve commodity from storage. Yada, yada, yada. This here is getting rid of hay and straw just over here. Excellent. I love the feel of this. This is very Eastern Europe. Sort of after, once communism was right across Eastern Europe, and there's, you know, the feel of it is very accurate, this map. I really do love the feel of this. It's fantastic. It's kind of like when a lot of these countries first sort of broke away from the Soviet Union, they looked like they sort of just stepped straight out of the 50s. and maybe even a bit before that. And some of them have struggled to get back on their feet. And this is like quite accurate. They will get what they can out of everything. Now that there's a lot of money coming, some of the places there's a lot of money coming in, and all of this is just being demolished. It's being completely flattened, and you've got brand new shiny stuff everywhere, which is looking fantastic. But this, the feel of this, this sort of closed off rural community is absolutely amazing. I really do like this. Anyway, I need to find a bank manager, so I will do that in a minute. I'll have a wander around, see if I can find him, and when I do, I will get back to you. Right, I have studied the map intently, and I can see a money note sign. If you look in the map, actually, I'll just show you one here. I can do this. Look, I can go here. Finances! Oh, I've been going right past it. Genius. Pure genius, that's what I am. Right, so our loan is at 75,000 euros. We need to get a bit more. How much more can we get? I think we can go up a bit. So I want to buy cows. And if you have a look here, there's cows there. So I'm assuming, because we've got cows here, that there, I think, is where you got to go, because it said you got to go and buy the animals. That's pigs. That looks like sheep. What's that? I don't know where the chicken... That might be chickens. It doesn't look... Let's have a look. It kind of looks like a chicken, I guess. Yeah, I'm not sure about that. Right. I want to get up there, and I also want to get a Joskin's trailer. That's got to be the farm shop there, but that... Anyway, we want money. So how many cows are we going to get? I want to borrow more money. So I can get a big pile of money, actually. Right, let's take this all the way up to 150,000. So we've got 90 grand so we can have a play around with. We're going to just go here and start this one up there. Let's get rid of that. We'll go and get this trailer. We'll run the trailer out to the combine. And actually, I'm going to come into cab and do this. Let's do a little bit in-cab work. We'll run out to the combine and unload. And once we've done that, I will take the cover. The cover is default as N on all of them now, so there's our trailer. This trailer's actually, the detail on this is fantastic. I'm really impressed with it. And we can put more than one. If you have a look at the back, that had a hitch on it. Right, let's zip over out here. Now, you've got a dynamic camera type thing going on with this, which means that you can... The camera will move up and down a bit as you travel. So we're going to come up here. We're going to unload the combine on the run as we go across the field here. And then we'll leave the trailer at the other end of the field and let it carry on. Can I do this while I am traveling along in cab? I don't know. We'll try. We are going to try and unload on the run. We've got another field being sown. We're going to go and get a Joskin's trailer, and we're going to use that trailer to bring some cattle down in a minute. Now, is that loader arm coming out? Yes, it is there. It's coming out. Need to get a bit closer. The straw does produce a bit of a bump there, which is slightly unrealistic, but I suppose actually, no, it's not. I mean, maybe it wouldn't produce quite so much of a bump, but it does produce a bit of a bump. So, yeah, what am I doing? Let's try and drive in a straight line. That would be a good start. And come back over the trailer. Right, I'm not very good at this. I need to... Yeah. Look. I'm doing it. Look at this. It's happening. Right, he can stop there. Excellent. Right, so now that I don't actually need to test my skill, we can come out and we can just take a quick look at how the trailer is filling up. I'm going to assume that when it's over the trailer, you've actually got to manually tell it to dump stuff to the floor. But can you put it over the trailer when the trailer is full and then initiate a dump to floor and have it just sort of pile up on top of the trailer so that it puts too much on there? That is an interesting exercise that we will try. I suspect that it won't. I suspect you just won't have an option to do that when you're... when it's over a trailer. Now, do we have a fertilizer spreader? We've got a cultivator over there, which might be useful. Do we have anything else at all? Let's just check our garage. I want to find out what we got. Oh, I'm in the garage. Right, we don't have a great deal here. We've got that one, which only takes seed. We have a cultivator, and we have a trailer. We really don't start out with a lot, do we? So we need a fertilizer spreader so that we can put a bit of fertilizer into the fields. And I'll come out here, and I'll put my beacon on. Now, we should have reflections from... Is that working? It should be a light reflection coming from the beacons on the signs. Maybe I need to go and activate that somewhere in an options thing. I'm not sure. But I don't actually know where I'm going. I haven't got a clue where I'm going. I need to get up to the shop up there. I've never played this map before. I did have a brief drive around when it first came out, but I've never actually played it at all. So it's quite nice to me, actually. I know that some of you did have played this map quite a lot, and I did have a few requests for me to play it as well. And it's kind of nice. I can now fulfill those requests for you, but at the same time, I'm playing something I've never been in before, so it's all a new, exciting adventure for me. So it's a win-win situation, I feel. Let's come on up here, and this looks like our shop. We've got a question mark over there. I'm assuming that's just to say that this is the shop. Yep. Right. So let's go and have a look in the shop a minute. I'll turn the tractor off. Let's go in here. We have that one. Vehicle shop. One stop destination. And... Ah, yes. R to go into the shop. Right. Back. We don't want that. Now then. We're going to need that one at some point. We don't need it yet. We need this one. I don't want to buy it outright. I'd rather rent it, to be honest. So let's select that one. Now, the lease is 2,640 euros. Base cost per operating hour. Doesn't have anything else there. Right. Nope, I don't want to buy it. I want a lease. Yes, I want a lease. Okay. Back and back again and back again. Right. Oh, it's put us inside. Can we pick that chair up? No, it doesn't let us pick the chair up. What about these over here? No, we can't pick those up either. Right, there is our trailer. Let's get that one hitched on. And the beacons stay on even after you turn the tractor off. Okay, we will have to remember to turn the beacons off or we will flatten our battery. I don't imagine that's a thing, but it would that would actually be really cool. If you could flatten your battery, that would be a very, very cool thing to see. They do seem a lot slower when you're reversing. Is everything going to be put inside here? If I get a giant machine, am I actually going to be able to get it out of this hall here? Right, let's back up there. There we go. That one's hitched on. Now, let's take a look at our options. Toggle active cruise control. Exit vehicle. Lower the livestock trailer. Let's come out of there a minute. What does lower do? Ah, I like it. I like it very much. Right. Now I need to go. I'm making vast assumptions here, but from my experience of playing this game, I'm going to assume that over by the bakery there, that would be where we got to buy animals. So how do I get there? There's a river that I got to go across. And then, well, basically I go back to the farm, and then I go in a straight line from there, pretty much, up to where the bakery is. Looks like the best way to go. Oh no, I can go out the back here and along the road, along the top. But I will do that because you don't need to see more boring driving around. You want to see me buying some animals. I just want to test this a minute. Okay. Apparently these don't all knock down. Oh, they all stay standing. That's a little bit disappointing, to be honest. Right, that there is a sell point of some sort, by the look of it. From the look of the map there. And if we go in front, there's a piece over here. So let's get our F1 up and see what happens here. We've got a box here for... Is this open animal dialogue? Right. Let's take a look at that. We want to take the cover off of our trailer a minute. And we want to lower the trailer down, I would say. We might be buying something. Can you open the back? Or does it not let you do that? Lift, exit vehicle. No, it doesn't. That's a shame. I was hoping it would. Right, open the animal dialogue. So now, if I click on here... right. Yeah, and you got one of six there, see? So if I go up Six is the maximum that I can get. It won't let me get any more. I think we're going to do this twice. We'll spend 60,000 euros and get 12 cows. Not really sure that we're going to get our money back anytime soon. We might have to go and do some grass and some silage. I have heard on forums all over... Let's just get those. I have heard on forums that silage has been nerfed a little bit, which is actually really good as far as I'm concerned. It does mean that it's going to be more difficult to... There we go. Let's lift that one back up. Get rid of that. And I want to just go straight down here, actually. Yeah, I think it's really good that the silage has been nerfed, because you could do one harvest of silage, fill the BGA up, and then that would fund your entire operation. You didn't have to worry about money after that. And that kind of... It kind of felt wrong to me, so I didn't like doing silage very much. So it has been... The costs have been lowered a bit, as I understand. There's been a few other changes made as well. Forestry is... Well, you still got... You still do get a reasonable price for your logs and stuff, but I think that the cost of it is a little bit more. There's like costs involved with it that have gone up slightly, so it makes it a bit more difficult to make your money out of it. So yeah, it's more slightly more realistic. Now then, Helper F has completed their task. Right, that'll be the one down in the corner down there. Let's bring this one over here and bring back up the screen here so we can see what to do. Open animal dialogue, lower light. All right, let's lower the livestock trailer. So what do we do now? Open the animal dialogue, I guess. I thought you could just unload them, but apparently not. Right. Just unload. Ah, right. So all I do is I mouse over. I don't have to click it or anything, and then just use the scroll wheel. And that loads or unloads. So if we click unload, confirm. Yes. Oh, that's a shame. I was really hoping that we would have some sort of animation there. It's nice that the trailer lifts up and down. That's really cool. I really do like that. That's a nice little touch. Can we go in here? No, we can't. But I was hoping that there would be some sort of animation for when the animals... unloaded, but there isn't. So we do have 6 cows in our field now. We will get another 6. We'll probably have to do that tomorrow because we are out of time. So let me just switch this tractor off and we will go and see. Right, press enter to switch it on and off. We've got another tractor over here. We'll just go and see that one. This field has now been sown. It was barley we put in here, wasn't it? Let's just make sure that they've picked up the edge of the field all okay. And there's a little strip, so we will just do this bit by hand. Unless they've run out of seed, maybe that's why they stopped. They could have run out of seed. No, they haven't. There's nothing wrong with you. What's the matter? Start you up. Okay, I'll try starting the hired help again. We'll see what he does. He doesn't like it. Right, so we need to turn it on, lower it down. We'll do it ourselves. Just that last little right. Helper J has completed their task. Oh, that was just the person here that was just in front of us. That was all. So we'll just finish that. That's it for today. That is everything. My question was, do you want me to do hard difficulty or normal difficulty on my time-lapse series? Head to the comment section down below and let me know what you think. It's your vote. It's your game. Tomorrow, I will be doing... Once again, I'll do an episode from each map. We will go and get another 6 animals. I've really got to go and turn those beacons off. I'll do that in a minute. Right, let's just stop you right there for a minute, and we'll run over here and turn these beacons off, because this is irritating me, this is. There. Right. I think the beacon should turn off when you turn the tractor off. That would at least be a good thing to do. Tomorrow, we will go and get the other 6 cows that we're going to get. So we've got 12 cows. We'll get something to gather up some of this straw. We may even try a baler. I'm not sure. But we need to gather up this straw. And on this map, we're going to be storing all of the straw. We'll put some in for the cows, and then we're going to find somewhere that we can stick loose straw. We're going to need a loader of some sort, I would have thought, to gather stuff up. And then we've got to see about making a bit of money. We've got a load of money. But we've borrowed it, so we're going to need to see about making some silage. So that is going to be our next main task, I think, here. We will obviously plough this up and get another crop in here. And we've got to do a bit of fertilizing, but the animals, they've got to take priority. And this guy's nearly finished, so he should be finished by next episode as well. If you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give me a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.